Hello again, this is LaZouche Custom here. Right, well, I'm going to do a review now on an unusual subject for me, namely a gas revolver. I'm not one for revolvers, but I'm quite taken with this one, I've got to admit. I may even consider getting one myself. The one I would go for is obviously the 6-inch version. This is Marui, by the way, Tokyo Marui. It's the Smith&Wesson M19, or the, I think it's the M66 is the chromed version of this. This I've managed to borrow off of a friend. It's the 4-inch version. And here's all the gubbins inside. Yes, the M19 or M66. The M66 is the chrome version. It's not a bad gun, actually. Look at all this nice plush red inside, like it, red velvet or whatever. Nice 357 Smith & Wesson Magnum cartridge box, which has got a muzzle cap, and I don't know what the eject shaft is. I have no idea what that is, but I don't know what that is. Actually, let's have a look, see what that is. I have no idea what the eject shaft is. What is that? Sounds interesting. Okay, yes, don't know what that is for, but I'm sure that the instructions will tell us. So let's have a look and see what the ejection shaft is for. It's going to tell us in here somewhere. Dun, 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 dun. Where's the ejection shaft? Oh, I see. Oh, to get the BBs. No, that's to fit the BBs. So where the hell's the ejection shaft used then? Doesn't say. At least not that I can see on here. So, no, there's... Oh, I see. Yes, there is. There we go. There's the ejection shaft. God knows what that is for. I presume it's to take the whole of the cylinder out. But, yeah, don't know. Anyway, that's what it's there for. It says to push it straight in. No idea what that's for, but there we are. We will have to wait and see on that. But, yeah, you get a good instructions manual with it. It tells you how to strip it down. I've also seen something already, being a 1911 buff, that you can use the rear sight. If you was going to do a Sven type 1911, you could use that rear sight. The Smith & Wesson 1911 revolver sights were fitted to 1911s, the early ones, before Bomar and Novaks and all of them came along. They used these sights, so, might see if I can get those particular sights as spare parts, but doubt anyone does them, but you never know. So, there we are. So that's all our little gubbins that goes in there. Shove all that back in there, BBs as usual, and your barrel plug. So that's that. You also get your barrel cleaning rod. Now then, let's get on with the gun. See what it's like. Put that away. Okay, what is the gun like? Well, I like the gun. It comes with three different types of grips, not this particular gun, but each version does. The 2.5 comes with a more wraparound, rounded but shortened grip, rubber, whereas these are plastic. I think the 2.5-inch one is also plastic, but it's meant to represent the Hogue rubber grips. The 6-inch one comes with wood grips, which is, love that. So as I say, I would go with the 6-inch, I think, myself. Now then, the gun itself is very, very good. It can be cocked yourself and fired, or it can be double action and fired. All right, as you can see, the cylinder rotates as well, so it's very, very good indeed. It's gas blowback, as I said earlier. Now then, to fit your BBs in, you just push this forward and that pops out. All right, now then, if I show you what I mean, see down in there, hopefully you can see if I put some light on. Oh, there you are, see that? That's what pushes that in. That little clasp there gets pushed in and allows this to pop out. Alright. Now then, the gas is blown down in through these rear holes because that's where you put your BBs in there. There's a collet, a rubber O-ring collet, with a spring behind it. You can fit four BBs in each chamber. It's not bad. The range is pretty good. Personally, if you want to get the most range out of this, I would put one BB in there. One BB, one BB, not the four. That way you get more gas power used for each shot, and the actual range of it is going to be a hell of a lot better. So that's what I would do, but there we are. Otherwise, you put four in each. So I think that gives you something like 24 shots, I think it is. which isn't bad really for a revolver. Had a hard job trying to get it out there. When you clip it back in, all you do is do that. All right, now there's, you may have noticed this side is flush with the back of the cylinder. As you can see, it sticks out, it's like a half moon shape that is flush. This side has got like a dent in it. I actually thought when I first reviewed this gun, oh my god, I've damaged it. But no, the reason why it's like that is so that this pin at the back there, which is sprung loaded, guides across it, pushes it in, and then allows it to lock against the inner lock pin. Alright, so that keeps it in place. So that's why that's bowed out like that. Rear sight's fully adjustable. You've got up and down movement, side to side, so you've got windage as well. Not that you'd ever really bother with that, but the front sight, as you can see, this gun has been used. It's got a little plastic red indent. It's actually stuck in there. I presume they've used super glue or something to stick that in there with. The foresight does feel a little bit, I don't know, flimsy. Just feels a little bit flimsy. Maybe it's just me, I don't know, but it does feel a bit flimsy. Oh, goodness. It's all mud over the end of this. You know, shows how much he cleans it. Anyway, well, he did give it to me at the end of a game, so there we are. The barrel comes right to the end. So you have literally got that length of barrel, which is dead on 4 inches. Accuracy's pretty good. I have put a few shots for it, and that's, as I say, where I come to the conclusion that putting one BB in gives you a little bit extra range. But obviously it cuts down on the number of shots, so you only get the six. I think it's six, isn't it? Yeah, one, two, three, yeah, six. So, yeah, it does limit you on shots, but it's a revolver, so, yeah. But you could go with the 24, I suppose, as it says, but that does limit you on gas power and range. Accuracy, as I say, is very, very good. So, rear sight comes with a little white sort of U-shape to line up the red at the front, which is very, very good. The sights are exceptionally good, actually. Revolver sights usually are, but these ones are very, very good indeed. The hammer to self-cock is very, very easy indeed, and the pull on the trigger is still quite heavy. It is quite a heavy trigger, I have to admit, even in double action, which you expect it to be heavy, but when it's already cocked, it's still a little bit heavy, so you do know that you've pulled the trigger. Now then, you're all wondering, where the hell is the gas filled? That's where it's filled, right down in there. Now then, if you've got a propane adapter, you may have a little bit of a problem trying to fill that. Now the valve itself is quite a shallow-ended valve, but to get to it, you have to go through the base of the plastic of the grip. So, yeah, that's a bit of a problem, I would have thought. But then a lot of the newer propane adapters have got longer tube ends on them, so they can go down to a greater depth. So, yeah, might be better, I suppose. Markings look like Smith and Wesson, but, or Wesson, I should say, not Western, Wesson, but actually, they're not. It's a very, very clever fake. But it looks like Smith & Wesson, but it's not. It's actually, it's TM, I think, but it's a really weird design. But anyway, it's got trademark written on it, which is weird considering they put Smith & Wesson on there, which is strange, but there we are. Anyway, so there we are. So the markings you've got Pro Grip for Revolver, Series Tokyo Marui Japan, it's got written on there. Pro Grip Marui, you've got Made in Japan, Gas Revolver Series, Tokyo Marui, Springfield, Massachusetts. Okay, a bit weird, but there we are. So you've got a mishmash of markings. Some correct, some obviously Tokyo Marui, and then you've got the ASGK written below. So yeah, very, very weird. You've also got Smith & Wesson .357 Magnum, which is the round. That's all correct. Very strange why they've done these markings like they have. I suppose it's to get around the licensing rules. I don't know. But, yeah, very strange. The gun itself is quite ergonomic to hold if you're a revolver person. I don't like revolvers. Never have done. I find them awkward to hold unless you've got a correct grip on it. The only one I do like to hold is the wood-gripped version, but that's smooth and can slip in the hand. These are quite rough and they won't grip, they won't slip. They have got these finger grooves in them, which does aid a little bit. Personally speaking, I find it uncomfortable. I don't know why. A lot of people say that revolver grips are far better than automatic grips, but maybe it's just because I'm used to automatic grips. I don't know, but yeah, I find it uncomfortable. However, if you're into revolvers, you will like this gun. It's nicely done. It's meant to represent blued steel, but to be honest, it's nowhere near as good as the Series 70 that Tokyo Marui released. This has got no brush marks on it at all. It's just a plain plastic, and yeah, it doesn't really do the job. There's a lot of mould lines here and there. I know that's, you know, nitpicking. It has got the ribbed top to the slide to the frame and barrel, which is correct. I mean, all the indents, all the marks and everything are correct, but it does look a bit plasticky. It's weighty enough. It is quite heavy. It does give you the impression of being a revolver, but it's not heavy enough. It's not equivalent to a real steel gun, so don't think that if you buy this you're going to have the correct weight. You're not. Looks, yes. Weight, no. But overall finish, not the best. Not the best. Personally, I don't know what the chrome one is like, but that's the one I would go for. If it's going to have the same mould lines as this, I know that's nitpicking, then yeah, 50-50 as to whether it's going to look the part. But this one looks okay, does the job, but is a tad plasticky. So that's how I would put it. But, as I say, if you want something like this for your loadout, if you're doing a US cop loadout or something like that, or you need it for some character that you're doing, then yeah, this is the way to go. Or if you just like revolvers, then Tokyo Marui are one of the best ones out there. There are other brands, I believe Tanaka, Marushin, they all do revolver type models. I'm not sure whether WE do any, actually. I haven't actually looked, but if they do, maybe you guys know, please comment below with any of your verdicts as to what they're like. But yeah, so revolvers are revolvers. They're a Marmite gun. You either like them or you hate them. Personally speaking, I would only have the 6-inch, purely because of the Clint Eastwood Dirty Harry character. It's an iconic character, punk make my day and all that. And it would get used in game. With an extra 2 inches on the barrel of this one, it would give you a hell of a lot more range, I would have thought, and better accuracy as well. So that's the only reason I would go for it. These shorter versions, the 4-inch, you're pushing it for accuracy and range. When you go to the 2.5, yeah, you're down to real close range CQB. I mean, let's face it, these are only ever going to be used for CQB. My friend did use it in a woodland game at the last game, and he said he was getting good ranges out of it, which I'm not going to say he wasn't, but personally speaking, I would keep this for CQB only, or as a backup weapon for CQB. So there you are. So overall, recommendations. Yes, it's a good gun. Yes, it works. It does what it says on the tin, so to speak. It's a revolver. It's a Marmite gun, as I've said. You either like them or you hate them. Me, personally, if I was, going to get one of these, it would be, purely if I had nothing else to get and I just wanted to spend my money, then I might get one. But other than that, it would be the 6-inch version for Dirty Harry, as I say, and it would just be purely an iconic piece, that's all. It works well. It's pretty meagre on gas, I've got to say. It seems to fire all the 24 shots and doesn't run out of gas, or at least it didn't for me. Maybe you guys who've used them more often can comment below and state that you've had good things or bad things with them. I don't know. But the overall review is pretty good. I would say it's a good gun to have, good as a backup, but as I say, it's a revolver. So I'm sticking with my blowback automatics more than these revolvers. The double action, single action feature is quite good. I do like that. There's no actual safety on this gun, not as far as I can see. I've looked for a safety, I cannot find one. So when that hammer is pulled back, the only safety you've got is your finger, because there is no other safety on this gun that I can tell, none whatsoever. So unless you keep your finger off the trigger, that gun's going to go off. Alright? So, yeah, safety is not a brilliant feature on these guns. So there you are. Anyway, guys, there's my review of the Tokyo Marui Smith&Wesson M19 4-inch gas revolver. It's a good gun. It's meagre on gas, so it's pretty good. It fires all 24 shots accurately and on target. Yes, I would suggest using just one BB in each chamber because you'll get greater range. But other than that, then stick with the 24 shots. You're still going to fire them out, but the range will drop a little bit on the last few rounds. So there you are. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the review. I know it's only a short review, but there's not really an awful lot you can do with these guns, to be honest. It's not like a gas blowback where you've got all the features of the slide and, you know, so forth. With this, it's just point and shoot, that's it. There's no moving parts. It's very quiet, as you heard on the previous times I've fired it. That's it. So it is very, very silent, let's put it that way. Maybe it'd make a good sort of silent kill gun, you know, for close range, I don't know. What I do like, though, I've got to admit, is the noise of the action. I mean, when you pull it or you cock it using the hammer, it's a nice click. It's a very nice click, I like that. The double action is quite quiet, actually, by comparison. There isn't an awful lot there. Whereas the single action, cocking it, there is a nice click to it. So I do like that. So there you are. So that's my review for this pistol. Sights are good. The action is pretty good. There's no real moving parts in this, so I can't see how it can go wrong. Regards to maintenance, just spray a little silicone inside the chambers in here, just to keep the O-rings moist and tight around the BBs. A little bit of sort of lubricant down in there might help for the inner workings, and obviously a little bit of lubricant down into the fill valve at the base there would help. To strip it, just go by the instructions. It's fairly easy. I would take the grips off first, then strip all of this out, and you'll see the gas cylinder or whatever. To take the gas fill valve out and so forth is fairly straightforward. You just need another valve key, which you can pick up at most airsoft suppliers. So yeah, just use one of those. It's a standard valve, so there shouldn't be any problems there. And that's pretty much it. But just maintain it. Like any other gun, as long as you maintain it, it will look after you. So, alright. So there we go. So that's LaZouche Custom saying stay sharp, but stay safe. Bye for now.